Okay, I'm ready to mat the inside. And this, because it's so long and wonky, is kind of what it looks like. This is what I came up with. I decided it would be best to mat the sides and the front flaps separately. Now, you can do it however you want to. I decided to leave the sheet exactly 12 inches long, and it is just shy of 4 inches. And I have my scoreboard out here so I can show you. You can see here, it's just not quite... Well, let me get that up there. I don't want to zoom in because my camera gets wonky when I do that. But you can see it's just shy of the 4 inches. I did that because in this area where these two go, it doesn't really give you enough to wrap. And I've been talking to Tammy Merrill about it, and she says, oh, just wrap it, it'll be fine. Well, probably it will, but I will know there's this little tiny bit right there that's chipboard. So what I did is I took Festive Berry Distress Ink, which is pretty close to this red, and one of these little heartfelt creation dauber things that Cheryl Wells had sent me, stack and store daubers. These are pretty good, especially, they're supposed to be used for flowers, but they're tiny. I tried a Q-tip and it didn't work. And I got right in here and I colored the chipboard here and I colored the chipboard here and just a little bit on this. That way there isn't going to be any chipboard that is going to show, and if it does show, it's going to be red. Nobody's going to notice it, and it won't drive me crazy every time I see it. So I cut a middle piece. Now remember, this is 8 inches, but we have a 2 inch, an 8 inch, a 2 inch, and then we have quarter inches between here that we have to get all of this covered neat and tidy. So I took a piece, and let me see if that's right. It's 12 and 7 sixteenths is about what it was. And I had, when I was experimenting before, I had pieced this piece. I don't know if you can see it. Right there. So you're not going to be able to mat this whole thing with one solid piece because you've got to have more than this 12, because the 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, these three pieces add up to your 12 inches, which is your sheet, and then you've got the quarter inches here. So my suggestion is to piece a piece, and I know you hate to do that, but just keep all the scraps. We'll use them as we go forward. And the same thing. This is 7 and 7 eighths I put. It's not quite, it's just a smidgen below, before that 8. So see, now that fits on there nice. If I slide this underneath and run it right up, and it's a really snug little fit there, and then we line it up at the bottom like that, and then this one will come under. I'm just going to have to do a lot of playing with the paper to get it to bend in the creases because I have several layers here now. But this is basically, see, how it's going to look when it's matted. So I'm going to go back and mat mine, and I am going to have, this is where my hinge system is going to be on two of these side pieces, and it will be three pages on each hinge that will flip to the middle. So I'm going to get all of this matted, and then I'll come back when I'm at the next step. Okay, see you later. This completes the construction of the outside of the book, the matting, and the covering. So let's make our hinge pieces. We're going to make two hinge pieces, and they are going to go on these side strips that were 2 inches by 8 inches. We want to have three hinges on each one so we can have three pages that go inward this way and alternate. So you want to cut two decorative pieces. I'm using the little bows. They are just a smidgen shy of the 2 by 8. Maybe 1 7/8 by 7 7/8, whatever, just enough so that you've got a nice matting in there. And then we want to make the hinge portion. Now, because I want half inch hinges, the part that your page is going to go over, I want to have quarter inch on both sides. That's so it will fit nicely in here. Now this is going to be, our book is 8, so these are going to be 7.5 inches and almost go to the bottom here. In fact, we might make them flush, I haven't decided yet. And I'll leave about 1/2 inch at the top in case we want to put any mats or something in there. So you're going to need a piece of paper, the red. You're going to need this to be 4.5 by 7.5. And then we're going to score it. The first score mark is going to be at 1/4 inch. And you're scoring on the 4.5 inch side. Then you're going to score every 1/2 inch, which would be 3/4 inch, 1 1/4, 1 3/4, 2 1/4, 2 3/4, 3 1/4, 3 3/4, and the last score mark is at 4 1/4, which leaves us 1/4 inch on the end. So let's get rid of the scoreboard because we really don't need it anymore. And now this is going to be this part. So we don't have to worry about that. And so we're going to take the next two and fold them up and push it down on the fold mark. And push that 1/4 inch down. See, so now you've got your 1/4 inch, which is gonna, you've got 2 halves. This is your first hinge. Now you can use score tape. I prefer to use the art glitter glue, but it's whatever you want to do. You want to glue these first two together like this, and you want to make sure that they're really nice and burnished with your fingers. You just keep working them. Once you think they're pretty well there, then bend them to the left and bend them to the right. Again, we're doing the same thing. We're breaking the fibers in the paper down so that the paper is maneuverable. It'll bend to our wishes. And there's our first one. We're going to do the same thing. We're going to skip 1/2 inch now. That's going to be our gusset. We're going to take the next 1/2 inch fold line and fold it, lay our hinge down, pinch it with our fingers. What we're doing is we're pulling the 2 1/2 inches together, leaving 1/2 inch on each side for our gusset. Pull it up, pinch it, and burnish it really well. Turn it over, either put score tape or your art glitter glue in the channel, whichever you prefer. And then the same thing again. We're going to burnish this really well. Make that glue go everywhere on there. We're going to pull it out, lay it down flat, and burnish it. Now be careful because you might have a little bit of glue seeping out from the bottom, so you want to clean that up when you're done. Now we're going to push it to the right or to the bottom, and to the top, however you want to say it. And again, there, and let's see. Now we've got 2 done. Our second hinge for our page. Last one, skip the 1/2 inch. Take the next score mark, lay it down on your paper. We're going to press it down so that the 1/2 inch, the 1/2 inch is here, the 1/4 inch is here, because we only have room to allow for 1/4 inch on the side. I've got a couple of pleats there that came up for some reason. Okay, let's put the glue in it and then we'll get this one done. I have never had any problem using the art glitter glue with the book coming apart. Just my own testimony. And I've been using it, oh my goodness, way over a year now. Maybe 2 years. I love it. Love it, love it, love it. Okay, this is the last one. Pinch it really good. You're only going to have 1/2 inch at the side. A little bit of glue there. And a 1/2 inch in the middle part. And 1/4 inch at the side. Okay, that looks good. Now we're going to fold it up, all of them up, fold it down, all of them down, again up, and one more time down. So we get that paper to know who's boss. We're the boss. Okay, now the next thing we're going to do, you can do it one of two ways. You can either attach your hinge to your paper and glue the whole thing, or you can glue your paper and then your hinge. I choose to glue the paper and then the hinge. Now, you're only going to have a smidgen, the top and the bottom. And your key is, you have a break here where your book is folding. You do not want this paper to be in that break, or it's not going to fold right. So you want to keep it to the left, but don't forget, you also have a break down here. So this time you have to be cognizant of both sides so that you're getting it right in the middle. Now I did use this Festive Berry ink that I showed you I used before, and I went around the outside because I like the appearance of an inked edge. There we go. Glue it all the way around. You may find that you've missed some spots and you have to come back and add a little bit of glue later, but that's no big deal. I'm just leaving a smidgen of the red show at the bottom, making sure I have a nice border here, and putting it down. Burnish it well, and then we can attach our hinges. And you know, I think I am going to put it right at the bottom because that will be easy to line this one up at. I want to leave a little smidgen of the decorative paper on both sides. And I'm going to put glue all over the back. Again, this is giving us 3 half-inch hinges with 1/4 inch on each side and 1/2 inch gusset in between. With that 1/2 inch gusset, we can have some fun and put some flowers or some bling or whatever else we want in it. Make sure that this side over here is lined up straight. That will keep our pages nice and straight. You want to put your finger in between and run each gusset down, and then the last. Then take your bone folder, push it down, push it down, push it down. Push it down. There we go. And here we go. Fold them to the, just like we did when it was on, when we were making them. Fold them right and left. And just keep working it in. There we go. And there's our 3 hinges now for our side pages. Now we're going to do a repeat of the same thing over here, making sure that you have it lined up with this outer edge, that your top part is free, and you're not getting in your gussets here. I would tend to stay to the right more than the left. Okay, let's glue this down. And our Santa Clauses have a direction, so just to be on the safe side, I'm going to make our bows go in the same direction as our Santa Clauses. Going to leave a little bit of that red showing over here. There we go. Now we have our other hinge. We can glue it down all the way around. Lots of glue. Doesn't take a whole lot of this art glitter glue to stick. I just want to make sure I have it on all of the surfaces. Okay. Now we line this up right with the bottom. So we're going to line this one up right with the bottom. And for some reason I have more showing on this one than I did on the other one. That's okay. I don't know quite what I've done there, but that's all right. And there we go. Add a little bit of glue right there that we want to get rid of. Now, we have room for, let's do this too, like I showed you. Turn it to the right, and then to the left. Oops. Make sure that everything is sealed down. Okay, so now we put our two sides in, and we have hinges for 6 pages. We're going to do a page, and the page is going to go this way. Then this page will go this way, and blah, blah, blah. So we'll have 6 pages in there, and these sides will be side waterfalls. So I'll be back, and I'm going to match something here on the back, too. Maybe a flip up and a flip down. Let's do that. So I'll be back with the next thing, but now you have your hinges in your book. Oh, the other thing, too, I wanted to remind you is figure out what you're going to be using on the front of your book. Now, because this is a split front, you're going to have to be cognizant of that, and whatever you put in here, you can glue on the top, but it's going to have to be free so that your doors can open to the right direction. Now, I've got all of these papers, and I was really thinking that on the front, where is he here? I wanted to put Santa Claus. So let me find him here. Here he is. I think I would like to put Santa Claus. And I'm going to fussy cut him out. And he will go down here. This top portion, of course, is going to be free to make the door be able to open. But the bottom part with the candy cane will be here and maybe even go around to the edge. I don't know yet what I will put on the top, but that's what I'm saving. So go through and see what papers you're working with and what you like, and put the ones that you think you're going to be using on your outside, put those away so that you don't cut them up and then you don't have anything pretty for the outside of your book. Okay, until the next time.